In the last video, I explained the electronic hardware for our beautiful DIY gauge. Today we continue with the coding and I will give some suggestions for some cool features that I haven't mentioned yet. We realized the hardware with an Arduino Nano. It's fairly simple and can be replicated even by a beginner. An experienced Arduino user will be able to transfer the solution to other Arduino boards. I just want to remind you which features we wanted. We would like to realize a display instrument with a stepper motor. For this we need a stepper motor driver, clipping functions and some functions for the startup process and for testing. An interesting feature is the adjustable filter, with which you can set the dynamic behavior of the pointer very nicely. And then we also have to control a dimmable lighting that looks really cool in my case. Actually, most of the features are in the software. I've made it a habit to give some hints in the header. It might be worth reading these. I read them myself in case I want to reuse the code later. By the way, it might be also worth subscribing to the Electronics Unmasked channel. Okay, back to the code. The actual code only starts here with some definitions. First, a stepper library is used, for which we have to specify parameters that describe our setup. Our stepper, the X27, has a step size of 0.5 degrees, so it takes 2 times 360 equals 720 steps for one revolution. And then we define the digital output pins that drive the stepper. I programmed a function that sets the gauge into a sleep mode, in case it doesn't receive a signal for a certain time frame. Of course, there must be also a wake-up function. We control this with these three parameters. If you set the threshold to zero, then it would never go to sleep. Next, we have the variables for the stepper control. Then there are many variables for reading the data from the analog inputs and for setting the digital filter. This is our setup routine. Since we want to use the serial port for debugging, we need to enable it and also specify the bitrate that we want to use. Then we activate the output pin for our lighting LEDs and we set the speed of the stepper. This command drives the stepper to the left stop. We are already in the main program now. We read the voltage at the analog input A0. Then we get a query for the sleep function. Then the settings for the features are read. You know, we can adjust these via potentiometers. The names of dead voids, they are the subprograms, tell you what they are doing. Then we define the input signal for our digital filter here. Audio max lock is our input signal. The variable gain is our adjustable gain. And then comes the filter tuning and our filter function. The filter output is converted into an integer variable, which we use to control the stepper motor. Now there is something special that I haven't mentioned yet. It is a startup function that shows us the zero value, the maximum deflection, the settings for the gain, the damping and the resonant frequency at the start. This is quite helpful, since you get the settings which you cannot derive directly from the trimmers. By the way, a strong signal will also trigger this function. With that, you can always check whether the gauge is working fine. And then we add the variables for adjusting the pointer to the dial that we use. The clipping function replaces the values that are outside the display range with a defined minimum or a defined maximum value. And then finally we drive the stepper motor. Okay, that was the main program. Now let's talk about the subprograms called voids. We have a print program and a plot program that we can activate if we want to debug via the serial printer or the serial plotter of the Arduino IDE. This is the stepper driver subprogram. Pretty simple, isn't it? Next, we have a function that generates a square wave signal for testing purposes. The next void is the filter function. You know, it implements this filter formula. I can recommend some interesting videos at the top right, where we show simulations and interesting effects of that digital filter. The variables for the filter tuning are set in this subroutine. The next void controls an automatic variation of the filter tuning. I used it for testing purposes only. Here is the subprogram that reads our signal from input A0 and transforms it, applying this logarithmic function, because I used the signal from a microphone. Acoustic signals have great dynamics, which I compress using the logarithmic function, so that they can be better displayed with an analog instrument. It is a common practice with acoustic signals. Next, we have the subprograms that read the potentiometers for the settings. They are all similar. The voltage at the analog input is measured. Then the values are smoothed to avoid fluctuations from possible interference. Next, we have the clipping function and the start-up function. The check-up function is only intended for test purposes. It can approach a specific value at regular intervals, which is useful if you want to test the maximum speed of the stepper motor. In this way, you can see if steps are lost over time. Finally, we have the void that controls the LED lighting. Now, one could reduce the code with fixed parameters instead of potentiometers, and without lighting control, you could create a kind of minimal version. One could also delete the startup functions, the sleep function, and the test functions. But I think with special features, makers' projects are getting more interesting. I hope I gave some good ideas for your own projects. Now I wish you a lot of fun. The coming videos are about a stylish housing and other applications for the display instrument. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.